You see the hand of God in the book. You see that God is interested in our
incredible.
You see that God is in control of everything that is happening in your life. Compare the story of Ruth with the story of Joseph in the
Bible.
The book of Ruth has confronted me a lot of
times.
Especially when I was wallowing in the things of this world. When I didn't know the Lord Jesus as my personal
Savior.
The book of Ruth was one of the books that the Lord used to show me the way of salvation. And to comfort me that God is interested in me. And also to show me that God has called me out for greater things. That I won't die until I have fulfilled the purpose for which God brought me to this world. The book of Ruth taught me that even though I'm from a very poor family
background.
God will make the way that I will sit with and find with it. That I will eat with presidents. And this is
a
president. That's the president. I said what?
Yes.
President.
Of course, now you go to only church.
Come in this church. Come on. I'm meeting with one. Yeah. Come on.
Your way is to like it.
I'm meeting with one. You know I'm going to be. What is it? Say, come on. Hello, so. What is it
about?
And I'm also eating with people that are more than this.
Your way is broken. What are they?
I'm not saying it out of pride. I'm saying it so that you now know that God is interested in you.
I'm a great man. I'm a chilling man.
And no matter where you're coming from,
now I am this way.
It doesn't matter. What matters is what God has called you out
of.
What God is planning to use you. After all, what type of people does God use? Is it not people? People of a low background. People
that
are insignificant in the society. So that God is more than glory. Because what do I have to boast of? To boast of my father
or mother.
I have to boast. I'll boast of my insignificance. I'll boast of nothingness. The great God, God has. That he has made me a servant. And
we
are here to listen to the word of God through me.
That's
already a miracle. We have the judiciary. The judiciary, their work is to interpret the legal system. What does the law say? And the executive, their work is to implement what the law has said. And that is for when they see somebody that is not contrary to the law.
Ya mere ọrụ na ịbụ onye na-agaghị ụzọ n'ụzọ soro gị iwu.
You should arrest that person.
Ha ga-ejikwa onye ahụ.
Taking to the people that can interpret the law.
Ha ga-ejikwa onye ahụ. Ka bụ onye ndị ga-akọwara gị iwu ahụ.
And ask them to see whether this what this person has done, whether it is repugnant or whether it is contrary to the law.
Ask na lee anya nke ọma, gwa m ya na anya mara ma ihe a onye a na-eme
ọ bụ usoro iwu. That is where the judges will come.
And
that is where the lawyers will come. Lawyers with their clients to look at the law.
Look at the offense.
Yeah, I have done this. And the law says
this.
So judge, look. This is the punishment of the
state.
The judiciary is not allowed to punish that person.
Ọ bụrụ onye iwu bụ ndị a ga-akpọ ya.
They will take that person back to the village.
A ga-ewere ya ruo ndị ahụ na-akọwa
na ebe ndị ahụ na this person deserves 100 years in prison or sentence by being
fined. A ga-akpọ ya na ọchịchị ya. Na onye a afọ ole na otu a iwu chọrọ ka ọ nọ n'ihi na o mere ihe otu a.
In this way, they are checks and balances. God wants to live
in
that is why when you want to marry,
you
don't just take one woman.
Or
you go to another and say, marry me. And
then
say, we are married. It's never done. You must go through the legal system, legal process. And the law of the country permits you to marry in one of these three ways. According to the customs. Anybody that is married according to the customs of the land is legally married. That is my act. Religious way. Once you are married or wedded in the church, you are wedded. Apart from this three
gates,
that woman can never be a wife. And any children born to you
can claim.
So that is it. And that is what we want to see in this
passage.
Before then, those of you that will not have followed, let me take 3 minutes. To explain the story of
Ruth so that you know better.
The story of Ruth is a story that tells us about one Moabite baby. That came back with Naomi, her mother-in-law. Yet there was a famine in the time of Judges. One woman called
Naomi
the husband does not have any objection.
What can we do?
It's good for men to listen to their wives.
Oh, we do have no pain and now we have.
But whenever she suggests anything that comes in accordance with the law,
sendo uma bola, obviamente, entusiasta, na época do raposo, e foi a pau.
Mas sendo o meu nome.
Mas, obviamente, não é a minha.
Sendo o meu explanation.
E a minha cor azul.
Então, me respeito a pergunta em minha mão.
A sua parte com you.
I said no.
A segunda.
Diga o meu nome. I said no, capitão. No.
One
day, we that there was food ahead in Bethlehem.
Naomi, no one. I said,
now it's time for me to go back to
Bethlehem.
Because she's a woman like a servant girl because of the
enemies.
She's a servant girl because of the stomach.
Anywhere
there's food, that is where she
is.
There was no food in Bethlehem.
When we read Bethlehem,
she left Bethlehem.
Oh, Bethlehem.
And went to
Moab
because there was food. No! There was food in Bethlehem. She left Moab.
Bethlehem.
I hope you're not
embarrassed. I'm not going to be
a servant of God for what
all we need to be.
I hope you're not like that in
Bethlehem. I'm not going to be a
servant. That is wrong for you.
Well, no.
And so she decided to that is your hope.
Chapra.